Evening, folks. This is Blessing Slot, and welcome back to our Planet Zoo Sandbox African Zoo build. Today, we're going to get started on a big habitat, a big hippo habitat, hippo harbour, to be exact. Now, this is going to be a two-parter at the very least. We're looking at about 3 hours of time-lapse, actually over 3 hours of time-lapse right here. And yeah, it's only about half done. This is a big project, possibly the biggest I've undertaken in Planet Zoo for a single enclosure. I just wanted to do something large, and this was an idea I'd had floating around. So the idea, you can see it being built here, we're doing the basics of the build, is a multi-tiered exhibit. You can't access the top via any way over the monorail, so there's going to be a monorail taking you to the top. Up there, there's going to be a dome, because we love our domes, and you'll be able to walk out in front of the dome, look down, and see the hippos below you. The hippos themselves are going to have a multi-tiered habitat, that's the lower tier you can see, and the middle tier will connect to the upper tier. If you wanted to get a little closer to the hippos, you'll be able to walk down, stand on that lower platform, and look into the hippo enclosure. Some of you may be expecting this already. If you follow me on Twitter, which you should do, I'll link it down below, I did post my drawing of this yesterday. This was a big exhibit, so I decided I needed to plan it out at least a little bit. I don't usually draw my enclosures out, but this one needed a planning stage. And I just think it's worth looking at the difference between my incredibly high quality drawing and the final enclosure. I will show you that at the end of the video. The time lapse here is going to last about 25 minutes. The speed build is really going to last most of the video. We're going to have a very short period after that, but I will show you the photo in that second part, just so you can see the difference. So yeah, there's the basic things. That this is our little ramp upwards. I did actually put this in the wrong way and didn't change it, but we're going to lean into that. And basically, the hippos be able to either hang around at the bottom, and that's where the river's going to be, so they're going to want to spend a lot of time there. But we'll put the food and the enrichment items higher up, so they'll come down for the river, and then they'll walk up around this little ramp, up onto that first tier, and that's where they'll have their enrichment and stuff like that, and that's where you'll get the best view if you're on top. There will be other ways of viewing this. We're also going to do a boat tour, stuff like that. We'll get to all that later on in the video. It was a long one, this. I woke up at whatever time this morning, spent about 5 minutes waking up, and then just hopped on Planet Zoo just to try to get this up moderately in time, which I have probably failed at. So there's the basic idea, just making that rock just so I can see what. It's easier to build in rock because you can see the edges a little bit more defined, you know, it's easy to see what you're building. This is going to be our river. This is, like I say, going to be a boat tour. We talked about this a little bit in the previous video. The idea is to have this boat tour that eventually is going to go through like a cave system. I saw this online. There is an actual zoo that does this. It goes like through this cave. It's all dark, and then you look to the left and like there's a glass panel. And through that glass panel, you can see, I think it's a tiger enclosure, the one I saw, but in our case, you know, a lion enclosure or something like that. You just look out in this little cave and this little boat tour just takes you around. I think it's a really nice idea, so I'm going to lean into that. So that's the river. The river's going to carry on for most of this side of the park, which, remember, is much more based on water and greenery and stuff like that, whereas the other side is going to be more rocky and dirty and stuff like that. And sort of, this is more, this is going to have more stuff like this, more human focused projects, more technology and stuff like that. Anyways, I was trying to put in a monorail. Unfortunately, it does have to be a loop, which I didn't realize at the time, so here's me looping it. I would have liked to do it so you just go up and down. I don't want you to have any other way to get up here other than the monorail itself. The idea being, you can go up there, you can look down at the hippos, or you can just look out on the entire park. You know, you can get a drink, sit on the benches, and look out across the entire huge park from this like really nice vantage point. So adding the monorail track up there, lovely stuff. I really wish there was a better way of seeing which way's left and which way's right when you're putting down the entrance track. I'm sure there is like a really easy way of doing it that I don't know, but I don't know which is left and right. Like, I know my left and right in real life, don't get me wrong, but when putting down the station, I really should just learn how the game figures it out. I assume it's the direction that it takes, essentially. Anyways, going to connect that up to our still elevated path. It is going to drop down at the forward bit. We're keeping this whole area nicely elevated. There's our little queue. And just going to finish this top bit, just so it's, yeah, I decided to move that to the other side. Like so, there you go. And then we don't have to deal with that. And we're going to put a nice little ramp over there later. But I just wanted this working. I was confused for really, it says testing. I was confused for ages. Why is it not testing? Why is nothing happening? Have I broken it? Is it just not working? It's because the game was paused. So, oh, whoops. Now, we're going to do a dome. I was checking my inspo out. Didn't really end up using it, but I really wanted, it ends up looking a little Colosseum-y. We might change things up a little bit, but I really wanted something open. This isn't meant to be a big shut dome. It's meant to be quite low to the ground and lots of open space and lots of glass and stuff like that. I really wanted it to be light and airy. I've got a little bit of a plan for how we're going to do the inside of it. We're not going to finish the dome in this video. We're going to focus on other parts. Like I say, this is probably a 6 or so hour build in total, and we're about halfway through. But anyways, I just wanted the dome to be very chill. I didn't want it to be over the top, and I just wanted to keep it light and airy. And as I've said before, this side of the park is going to have more of that dome focus than the other side will. I really want to not necessarily not have the domes on the other side. We're going to have a couple, but I do want it to be more of a clear feature of this side of the park. I considered doing a basket, but I decided against the basket. I think I decided against basically everything, actually. Yeah, so I'm just going to do a roof. It does go up slightly, but I really didn't want this to be tall, so it only goes up by 1 meter and then it goes flat again. Again, the idea being, I just didn't want it to be intimidating or massively huge. It's just meant to be a little bit of cover when you're up there. And I'm going to do a bit of a water feature in the middle. I've got an idea for one that I really like. Again, based on Pinterest. I resisted Pinterest for so long. I really did. But it's just, it's so helpful. Now, my reasons for hating Pinterest personally is because it ruins Google Images. Like, all the time, you'd find a really cool image on Google and then it would take you to Pinterest and you wouldn't be able to access it because I didn't have an account. And I refused because of that, but Pinterest, you win, okay? I've got an account, I'm using you. Be happy about it. Bloody Nora. Anyways, there's our dome. I like to use the ice because I really like domes that have got this sort of empty middle, because I think getting the sun in and the light in is really cool and kind of part of this park. I do want to put those in as well, but not yet. So I tend to use the ice, and then what we do is we build it and then we just get rid of the ice, and that gives you like a perfect empty circle in the middle. It's quite hard to figure out otherwise. If you try to do this without doing a block, you know, if you just left the gap, it'd be quite hard to get it perfect, I think. I'm going to bring in more ivy. It's going to happen a few times because, again, this area is meant to be a bit more lush, a bit watery, you know, a little bit foliage-y, all that kind of jazz. So let's build our dome. I see it, same way we always do, just rotate it a few times and stick the pieces together. It looks pretty nice. It's nice and open. Might have to mix things up a little bit, but yeah, just using the archways. I didn't want it to feel like a big enclosed spooky building. We're not about spooky buildings, we're about sexy buildings. Oh, it's one of those days, folks. It's one of those days. So, not much to say about this one. The track will go through a little bit nicer. I will sort that out. The car does clip on the roof right now, but like I said, we will fix that. Gonna get rid of all of that ice baby. Takes a billion bloody years. And there we go. Yeah, it's not too dark, it's not too spooky. Kind of what I'm looking for. It actually might be too dark still. I'm considering getting rid of some of the thatching. I really do want this to be not terrifying. Like, not that it was a terrifying, I just really want it to be light and chill. Chill. We're all about the chill. I'm going to try to put the path in. I've really not built a lot of the actual enclosure yet. I was going to have this tunnel through, but it just looks stupid, so I'm not going to do that. I just kind of wanted to really get the basics in, so I kind of knew what I was building, and I kind of knew what I was aiming for, and how it was going to look. Realizing there just wasn't enough room there, I decided to expand that, and then thought, oh, you know what we can do? The car goes through there, the monorail, why don't we have it? The path needs work there, but why don't we make it go through the mountain a little bit? That'll be pretty cool. That'll just be an interesting little thing that happens during your monorail journey, I guess. I was going to attack it with a chisel, but again, that kind of landscaping, that rough kind of landscaping with the chisel tool that I love so much is something we're saving for the other half of the park, so it's something I want to try to avoid on this half. But that's the basic idea of what we're doing right there. Was going to go for an elevator, so I got rid of that. Path just curls around the side, there'll be a wall there and fence there. This will all be done nicer when we're actually focusing on this bit, but that's the basics. You'll walk at the end of that path, you'll look out over the fence, you'll look down and see the hippos. We'll of course have to block off these sides a little bit because people will just tumble to their death willy-nilly. Just testing out the car there, obviously it does clip, so I decided to just basically just remove the archway. Kept the vines, I think it looks pretty cool. And we've got two little entrance bits for the car to go. I like that the car comes into the building. I think that's a nice little detail. Looks cool. It does look a little bit like a Colosseum. Reminded me a little bit of the Colosseum I built for the lion enclosure back in our franchise zoo. But honestly, this entire zoo reminds me of my franchise zoo, so that's okay. Now we're going to do a lot of rocks. There's going to be a lot of rocks. Now, generally speaking, excessive rockiness is again a thing that will be reserved for the other half of the zoo. I was considering doing, you see it a lot in actual real life, I've seen people do it on Planet Zoo, they just kind of wrap around actual materials, you know, plaster or brick or something in a circle, or a curve. Imagine replacing that rock with brick, basically. But because this is part of the exhibit, and because this is our African zoo, and we tend to lean in a little bit more of a naturalistic kind of angle, I decided we're just going to use the rock. There is more rock than I'd want, but that will be less of a case later on. Gonna do a little waterfall over there. Yeah, there's gonna be a while now of just putting the rock here, basically. We have to fill in that little hole on the... That's a terrible joke there. We have to fill that hole on the right because the hippo will go through the hole. The hippo will escape through there if we allow it. We will be bringing the hippos in at some point during this time lapse, just because it's always very helpful to have the hippo... Why are people applauding? I have no idea. They were filming a film outside the British Museum the other day. Like, there's loads of cameras, people shouting action, and then people started clapping. There's like some head of state looking guy walked into the museum. Happened like 6 times. For reference sake, I live literally opposite the British Museum. I can see it out, like, the entrance gate is opposite my window. It's a nuts place to live. I need to move. Right, there's like a very rough idea of what we're looking at here. So there's the rock wall, we're gonna do another rock wall, and let's put in the actual hippo enclosure itself. I think you're gonna be able to view it from that side, you know, the wall I just did, but the reason I'm putting it in now is because we need the hippos in. So we need a way to add a staff gate more than anything else. And there's our hippo wall, lovely stuff, goes across there, bingo, bango. It is just enough room, I did check. It's a little bit tighter than I would have liked, but yeah, hippos are oddly picky. That path is temporary as well, but we needed a way to get the staff in. So here we go, buying our 2 hippos. We'll meet those properly later on in the video, of course. Waiting for them to arrive. Now, I was hoping the only escape route would be the river, and you can see it isn't. There's a little error there, so just bring that out, flatten that down a little bit, check them again, and we are good. So they can go into the river and walk out, but that will eventually not be a problem. I can fix that. It's actually a little bit tricky to have a boat ride go through an enclosure and have the animal not escape. You kind of have to... There's no gate. What would be really cool is, you know, like for the car ride, we have a gate that they can go through, and the animals don't go through it, but the cars do. Unless I'm utterly crazy, I'm going to check again, but unless I'm totally crazy, I don't think we have an equivalent for the boat. What you have to do, and what I did at least in my franchise zoo, was kind of layer loads of rocks around to the point where the boat goes through, but the animal can't squeeze through the gap. Now, I'm happy to do that, but it wouldn't be my first choice. I'm hoping there is an alternative, but I just don't think there is. I don't think the boat is meant to go through enclosures, I guess. I know when we did our crocodile tour in My Pen Rye, we used the rocks and we blocked it off. So, anyways, rocks. It's meant to look natural, but also slightly man-made. It's controlled, it's where I want the rocks to be, it's there to A, stop the hippo tumbling off the cliff, but B, just to make the wall look a little bit more built up rather than just, you know, mounds of dirt, essentially. I just wanted to give it a little bit more structure. Nothing particularly complex. Always like to have my little baby rocks at the bottom as well. Again, just trying to make it look a little natural, but not overly so. It is a man-made enclosure, very much so. I can't believe this is taking so long. I thought most of my focus wasn't on this bit, but that's half the video right there on the actual enclosure building. I'm going to do a little water feature here. Just imagine the water's passing through both sides of this rock. It was originally going to be a waterfall, but I didn't like the idea of sinking everything down. It made the boat difficult to access. It made the whole thing a little bit annoying to build, so just going to do a little water fuzzy thing there, basically. There's our hippos. What are we doing now? Yeah, adding our little waterfall. The waterfall's not done either. Because this is such a big build, I kind of just didn't... It sounds daft, but I didn't really have a plan for how... I mean, I had a plan for what I was building, but in terms of the order, it was basically what inspires me now, what inspires me now, what inspires me now. Oh, I've got an idea, let's go do that. It was very much not methodically completed bit by bit. I really preferred just doing the bits that interested me at the time, essentially. Bringing back our stickers, because these were part of the giraffe enclosure, and therefore they're going to be part... I think we're going to use them in basically every enclosure. Was going to put these in, decided against it, I believe, any second now. Just because we've got the fence on the other side, I decided to bring in the fence again. Basically, the, whatchamacallit, wire. Mesh, steel mesh, that's the one. So hiding the end of it in there, and then we're going to bring in the wood sticks again. Again, because the giraffes and the hippos live in the same, I believe the north? Is it the south? I actually can't remember. I'm going to go with the north, but it could be the south side of the park. So there's going to be a few things that are common themes across all the enclosures in each side of the park, and the sticks is this side of the park's theme, at least partially. Like, obviously there's more than that, it's not just sticks. Had to change my music there, but the sticks are going to be a common feature. I like how they look. I know they're usually for to stop things climbing out, basically. I think it's an anti-climbing mechanism, but I just think they look pretty cool, so I'm going to keep bringing those in. Now, in terms of the actual enclosure, I think we're basically done. There's going to be a boat tour that's going to go through there eventually. That's something that's going to develop across the entire series. Most of the video is now going to be spent building the introduction to Hippo Harbour, including googling what hippo is in Afrikaans, which I can't remember. So it's hippo and it's, what's that? Cicopi. Cicopi. It's a cute name. Cicopi and hippopotamus. I wanted to do like a little version of our entrance sign, but this one's specific to the hippos, so we're going to call it Hippo Harbour because it looks like a harbour and there's a boat. It doesn't look like a harbour, but there's a boat. And it has hippos, basically. So basically you're going to walk on the main path, and if you want, you can turn to the left and go down Hippo Harbour, or you can carry on walking forward into the rest of the park. I'm not sure how much I'm going to split the park into. Like, the left side is definitely going to be certain animals, and the right side is going to be certain animals based on what we've said, you know, the north and south divide. But whether I want to entirely actually split the park in half, I'm less convinced. I'm going back on that a little bit as an idea. Anyways, do I spell harbour correctly? I spelled my park name wrong last time. I think I get harbour right, yeah. Hippo Harbour, look at that. I love this font. Ricey's just my favourite person in the world, honestly. Yeah. So just building a little sign, really. No plans, just kind of wanted it themed similar to the other one, so just gonna stick some mud in there. Doesn't have the text on this time. I was gonna do it in Afrikaans, but the Afrikaans text is huge, the font we use. We will be using it again down the line, but for now I thought we'll just, you know, we'll do it in English, basically. Hey, it looks cool, it looks cute. Just bringing in some of the same elements again, essentially. I want it to be the same, but like a lesser version of the same thing, you know, like a scaled down version of the same thing. And I think we do a pretty good job of that. That will say exit eventually as well. Hippo Harbour! I love this park, I'm really enjoying this build. Sometimes I think I need to do videos more often, but with Planet Zoo, honestly, inspiration is so important. Like, having ideas and being inspired to build. I know that Geekism didn't do Planet Zoo for a long time. He was talking about this on Twitter recently, because he was just burnt out on the game. You know, a lot of us played so much of this game during the beta and in the early months because it was the new big thing, and you kind of want to capitalize on that. But if you're burnt out on Planet Zoo, it's a difficult game to play, at least like this. You know, if you just want to make a chill build in Franchise or Sandbox and not worry to, shut up, world, and not worry too much, you can absolutely do that. But to do like a large scale build where you try to be creative, I think is quite difficult to do all the time. You know, you need a break every now and again. So in the interest of not like burning myself out, I'm gonna not rush it. If I'm inspired and I want to do 3 episodes a week, then we'll do that. You know, at the moment I want to finish Hippo Harbour, so I'd imagine the next episode will be pretty soon. But if I'm not feeling it, then maybe it'll be 1 a week, blah 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 blah. It'll still be consistent, but hopefully that makes sense. Anyways, it's a hippo. I decided the building needs nothing particularly complex, but I just wanted it to, I didn't want it to just sit there. I needed something, you know, to look a little bit more like an actual station of some description. So I'm just gonna give it a little roof and some walls, essentially, using our beloved mud. I really like the mud. The mud's really grown on me. Not really messing around with the colors quite yet in the mud. That's something we probably need to do. Maybe that could be a feature of the other side. The other side is gonna have a problem where it's all rock and dirt, and even the trees are less colorful on that other side. So maybe what we need to do is bring in the colored mud on that side, and that can be like one of the features. I do want to do like an African village, like actually rebuild an African village at some point, and maybe making that into an enclosure, and you walk through the African village and there's like a little animal roaming around. I don't know what animal we'd have over there that would work with, but I'm sure there is one. So you'll walk through this African village and the animals will be darting around. I think that'd be really cool. Now, lots of trees. Like I said, this side is going to be more lush and green and stuff like that, but this enclosure in particular is going to be even more lush and green than most of them, just because it's the hippos and it's watery and it's harbory. I just kind of felt it suited that slightly, not a swamp, but closer to it. Oh, I forgot the lily pads. I was meant to add lily pads. Oh well. So it goes in that direction, but not entirely. I've been playing a lot of Red Dead Redemption 2 lately for the first time. Like, I played it like when it first came out. I played about an hour and then I didn't touch it, but I played, I don't know, 30 hours or so in the last week or something. And I just got to... I take my time. I've been focusing on hunting and stuff like that, don't get me wrong. But I just got to the bit in the bayou and everything. So I'm kind of in a bayou kind of mood. I'm in a swampy, bayou, crocodilian kind of mood. Unfortunately, no crocodiles in this park, but... Oh well. I do love the elephant grass, but I did go a little hard in here, and I get rid of all that stuff in the middle, and I reduce the stuff on the right-hand side, and I do knock down the elephant grass at least a little bit, so don't panic if you're thinking, that sure is a lot of elephant grass there, best in slot. I agree, and I will be calming down on it briefly. But yeah, this is just going to be our little, how long have we got left, like 6 minutes? Yee. 5 minutes. This is just a little entrance walkway, basically. You'll just walk along here. You've got a hippo harbour. If you want to go onto the boat, you walk off to the right-hand side. That path isn't there yet because we haven't built the boat harbour. That's going to be part of the next video. There goes the grass. And if you want to go up on the monorail, you just walk to the left, essentially. And then you come back the same way and you leave. I mean, it'd be nice if there's an alternate path in and out just for people who are exiting, people who are entering, but I think that's going to complicate things, so... I'm gonna stick with this. Watching this now, I've just realized I've used the wrong path. This is the default path, the middle one, but we have another path that we use for the enclosures. So remind me, somehow, magically, break the time-space continuum. When we come to our building bit at the end of this, and I'll show you the photo and stuff like that, when we actually play the game and not time-lapse, remind me that I need to change this path. It needs to be the wooden texture one. Otherwise it will stick out a little bit too much. I'm still thinking about how we're going to organise the rest of the park. I really like this, and I think the positioning makes sense, but... I don't need just to be like a line down the middle, and you go to the left for this exhibit, and you go to the right for that exhibit. At some point, there has to be a loop. So I think what we do is we have the path split off. I'm just doing a little introduction there. As usual, our animals will have some weird names. Thank you for the giraffe suggestions. I will be adding those before the next video. This one is called Water Blob. But I will need new names as well for the hippopotamus, so feel free to hook me up. Just putting a little roof here on our little hut. We're going to use the colours, the yellow and the green are very much associated with this half of the park, so just do a little wooden slapped pattern roof thingy. Looks quite cute. On this side, there we go, lovely stuff. I ended up adding a wall to the back of it as well, just to make it, again, feel more like a complete station, essentially. There you go, lovely stuff. Just chill, no big deal, chill. A chill little station. There's me, I think the grass is a bit too much, knocking it down a little bit. I'm gonna bring in a signpost as well, just to point out where the entrance is for the monorail and where the entrance is for the thingamajiggy. But what was I talking about? I actually don't remember. Huh. What was I talking about? I actually don't have a clue. Wow, okay. I don't have a functioning memory. It's very upsetting. I wish I did. I really wish I had a functioning memory. But whatever I was talking about 20 seconds ago, has disappeared from my brain. I actually don't remember. I was going to show you something. Oh, we're going to change the path. Oh, yeah. So, I'll probably plan this out a little bit later on, but basically I think... You go left for the hippo, and you'll go right for something else, and then that'll loop, 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 loop. You know, kind of like zoos tend to be a loop, right? So you'll walk down to the left to get the north animals, you walk down the right for the south animals, and then in the middle, in that empty gap in the middle, is where we'll do our uniting one, I guess. Or, yeah, I think that's the only way to do it. The problem is I don't need to walk around and have to walk around again. This is interesting. We'll talk about this later. Anyways, adding some vines and stuff, adding, sort of reducing some of the elephant grass down. Wasn't really sure what to do with that middle bit. The middle bit annoyed me. I might put a wall there, but for now we're putting some palm trees in, kind of getting a little bit of that, do-do-do-do kind of feel going on. A little bit of water, because it's watery. Bringing in a little sand. Sand is definitely a texture more focused on the other half of the park, but I like the idea of like a little oasis. I think that suits this side pretty well. So bringing some sand in, especially where the palm trees are, because I just, thematically, I get one T word each video, okay? I've used it this time, there it was. T word, I think it just makes more. It just feels right to me, essentially. So I like to mess around with the sand where the palm trees are. We are very nearly done, ladies and gentlemen. If you can see why this took so bloody long. I think usually what I wouldn't have done is do all this entrance work and all this design work in this area. I would have focused on the enclosure itself, but I think this is an important thing to include. There's a little water hippo, bringing that little sign, queue here, exit only, just little things to make it feel real. Of course, I'll give you a nice slow tour of this very soon. I decided against that. I don't like how that looks. I do like my little colourful things, but yeah, I'm just going to bring this. Honestly, these ropes are amazing, because they're just... If there's one problem with them, the rope is really long, so it means they don't fit like that, right? It doesn't fit properly, but they just, you get the feeling that it will stop people dying, but it very easily lets people see into the enclosure and stuff like that. It's kind of like a really cool combo of visibility and not being dead, which is my favourite two things in combination together. So, well, about 20 seconds left. Just enough time to confess my love for you. I had a slight problem with the water here, it wasn't really working. Or was that earlier? I can't remember. Oh, it was here. It turns out, you can't put the water in whilst the hippos are there. That was actually the problem, I didn't realise it blocked it. I'm a little apprehensive about this, about building the river, because I've had this a lot of time. Remember in My Pen Rye, we had this problem? Sometimes you'll fill a river, and you'll add lots of stuff down the line, whatever, and then you'll get rid of the water to add things, because water does block things, or maybe you want to, like we do here, we have to extend this river a lot further. It's going to go around, you know, five more exhibits or something. So you'll empty the water to extend it, and then you'll try to refill it, bloody Nora, and it won't work. It happens surprisingly often, so I'm checking constantly to make sure I can still refill the river. Anyways, I'm going to show you the photo. We're going to plan for the future. I'm going to show you the park. Let's hop in. Okay, here we go. Shut up, world. We're going to leave it on pause just because our hippos are going to be low welfare for a little while and also fairly hazardly contained at this point in time. But I'm going to give you a little bit of a tour of what we've done so far. So let's go into Tejid Camp. There we go. Lovely stuff. Hide the UI. And let's go have a look. So we have our welcome to the Odyssey Run. I'm gonna lean into my pronunciation, even if it's wrong. There's our two sides, our Guardians of the North and South Realms. Is this the North then? I'm gonna go check. You know what, we can check this super easily. Just run over here, back into the main orb, and down here. It's the North. The North is the lush one, and the south is the slightly drier one. But that's where we're gonna have all coloured buildings. It's gonna be very cool. Anyway, so we're heading to the north. Let's just double check that. We're heading to the north. Here we go. Be better if it wasn't paused, but as is life. So you cross over. So this is the idea then. You'll go left and like carry on down here, and that's gonna be the north, and then I think we're gonna split off here, and that's gonna be the south. Big circle around there, you know, like a zoo. Zoos tend to be in loops, so you can just go around once. And then, I'm trying to think about how to do it. I kind of need the entrance to the middle bit to be here, right? Because then it's at the point, so you go either north route or the south route. You're going to loop back here, because they'll link together. And then you'll head down to the middle for the finale, essentially. Now, the problem with that is you could walk in and go there first. So I think the only thing we can do, unless someone's got an alternate suggestion, is basically have a sign here. Like, so you, that'll go that way, that'll go that way, and then you'll walk for it a bit. This will be the middle bit. Maybe have a sign here saying, we recommend you complete the rest of the zoo before coming into here for the story, or something like that. It'll be something like that. I think that's going to be the idea going forward. And it'll look cool. There's a little hippo. Anyways, so remind me, I need to change the path. There's Hippo Harbour. Let's have a little... I really want, like, a middle walking speed. This is too slow. But the other ones are too fast. But there we go. Okay, we'll walk through the vines. You know, I like selling. I like my theming. You know I do. I'm big on the theming. There's a little hippo there. There's a hippo there as well, chilling on the rock, having a grand time. I like him though. He looks like he's actually real. We've got the monorail entrance. There's a little water blob sign, a little lamppost, and our boat trip entrance, which will be obviously this will one of these will have to be destroyed. One of these ropes, and there'll be a path taking you down over here, so we'll clear that out at some point in the future. You gonna let me back on the path? Cool beans. Yeah, so that's that. Here's the exit. There's a little slatted colour. I really like it. I'm going to do that more often. I think it looks really cool. That kind of slatted colour stuff. A little hippo in the middle. Zoom back out. Honestly, when I show it like that, it feels like I've not done any work. But this took bloody ages. And then, so the monorail links up around here. Chuka, 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 chuka. We'll have to build like a little station over here as well. Probably one that matches the one at the bottom. And here is our dome with its little gaps there. I might put some logs on these glass bits where the empty bit is, just so it doesn't... Oh, hello, cheeky. Just so it doesn't look so bare bones, I guess. Yeah, so I've got a little bit of an idea for this middle bit, because we're going for that wateryness. I think what I'm going to do is try to build like a mini dome that matches the size of this inner circle. And it's going to be basically a glass wall. And then in that, there's going to be like a big water feature and a big tree in the middle, kind of like the main dome, but much more watery, essentially. I don't really want to go too hard in here in terms of shops and stuff like that. That's not really the idea for this. It's meant to be a viewing zone more than anything else. So you'll walk in. I think we'll just block off that back bit. Be a dome in the middle with lots of trees and plants and water. And you'll walk from here. You'll walk around here. There'll be a path out here. You'll walk out here. And that is a pretty cool view right there of the rest of the... Doesn't that look really good? So you'll look out here at the rest of the park. You'll be able to look down at the edge, down at the hippos. And if you want to get a little bit closer to said hippos, then you walk down here. I will neaten that path up. And you walk here and there'll be a little fence here, but you'll be able to see the hippos when they come up here as well. That's the idea. Generally speaking, obviously, we're going to make that waterfall make more sense. I'm not really sure what to do about this. It's like a big blob at the moment of like texture. I can put some rocks in it and stuff, but I don't want to cover the whole thing in rocks, so I'm not sure what that's going to look like. I'm thinking if we just cover the area in trees and put a little texturing in there and some rocks, maybe a bit of water around the base, a bit of water up there or something, we can make it look okay. I don't want to go too hard on the plants because it is meant to be Africa and it's not really a jungle, but I say that, but here we are. It looks like my pen right all over again. I don't know, it's a boat tour, you know, it should have this kind of feel to it for me. It's a harbour. Stop vibrating, there's something going on. My bedroom keeps vibrating. Can you hear that? Chugga 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 chugga. Just stop it. That's about the idea, so... Rock wall there, hippos chill here, they walk up there, they hang around up there, or they hang around down here in the water as they were doing. This will eventually be a gate, and the boat will carry on. This path's going to go that way. Exhibit, 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 around there. Yeah, cool. Alright, that's about it. That is the plan. I'm going to replace that path. We're using, I think, tree bark, aren't we? So that's going to start there. I just think it looks really cool having a different coloured path. I think it just... It's nice to know that that is like it's like a separate little section. I want my animals to feel like events, you know. I want them to feel special. And I think having the sign and all the theming and stuff kind of leans into that pretty well. So this bit is done, I think. I'm pretty happy with that. I've done a little bit of work over here. I do need to put... I really regret this. I really like how this looks. And it's a cool viewing area, but... Oh, what's going on there? But. The problem is it's just so... out of the bloody way, you know, it really is. So I'm thinking we're just gonna put loads of trees and texture, and I'll bring up the terrain there, and we'll just block that off. And if you want to come down here and see the giraffes, you can, but you are gonna have to walk back, and it's a bit of a trek, so be ready for that. I was considering having a bridge over here, and then maybe we can take the park over in that direction. That's still a possibility at the moment. The river goes that way, but maybe it comes this way, and the park leans around here, have animals in there, and that's your north side, basically, in that gap there. The path going like that. And that way I can connect this to there via the path. At least then it isn't totally useless. But that's just the theory at the moment. I think we'll do, like, one at each side, so... Are we either gonna do the north completely at once, like, in a row, or we're gonna go north, south, north, south, north, south. I'm not sure yet. Oh, lots to think about, but I'm happy with how it's working out. So the intro is very much done. Next video, what do we have to do? We have to link up with the boat, first of all. Wait, how the hell do I do that? Wait, no, that's fine. I was going to say the hippos will escape, but the hippos can't actually... I'll just block it off with rock. I don't know what else to do. We have a gap here. We'll probably get rid of both of these fences here. Put some rocks there, put some rocks there, and the hippos shouldn't be able to get up there. You're going to walk down here... under there, and that'll connect on to there. So this area will need some decoration as well. I kind of put the rocks there already. That's kind of like the boundary of the harbour kind of thing. Obviously, the actual hippo exhibit itself needs a lot of love and decoration and plants and stuff like that to look cool. And then this whole area up here needs a little work as well. So we need to do the middle bit and wrap the path around there. And put some trees and stuff on there, probably. There's a lot to do. This is why it's a two-parter, because if this was a one-parter, it would be so... Like, the video would either be twice as long, which would be insane, or I'd have to do, like, a 15-time speed time-lapse, which just wouldn't be any good for anyone. Right, so yeah, hopefully people like the build so far. Oh, I didn't show you the photo. Here you go. One sec. So that is what I've got so far. Okay. Pretty happy with it, I'll admit. And this is what it came from. That was my inspiration. That right there... That top bit in particular. Maybe let's zoom in onto it. Wow, that's really annoying. Anyway, that top picture is the one that led to this. I think that's pretty cool. Like, you can take so just an atrocious drawing, really. And you can kind of see what I was getting at. There's a river there. There's the dome at the top. There's the little walky bit, because that's the where the hippos walk up. You can see it's actually a different direction than I was planning. The river goes on there. There's the monorail going up to the top. It makes sense. It just, yeah. Anyways, right, so next video we'll work on the main part of the enclosure itself. We'll work on the top bit, and yeah, feel free to give suggestions for the build. I'm gonna have to do something about these rocks. I think maybe having those go up to the waterfall and then wrap down is a better idea. Give suggestions for the build or how we lay out the rest of the park. I think I'm just gonna just block this part on the left off, and I kind of want the loop to go more like this. Rather than round there. I think that's going to be better. I definitely do want that. So that's what we'll do. Left that way. Shoop, shoop. It's going to be cool. Thank you very much for joining me, my lovely ladies and gentlemen. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Let me know if you did it in the comments down below. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.